here things are more complicated. First, I think the lesson of so-called virtual sex, it's a much more tragic one. It's not this humanist idea, there was some good old time when sex were authentic, encounter with a real flesh and blood person, and now we are just doing it. No, what we learned through virtual sex is that sex in a way always was virtual. Virtual in the sense that I already described it. Yeah. That precisely, how should I put it, Lacan, Jacques Lacan says somewhere, I think, that sex has a structure of masturbation. In the sense that, as I said already before, you are never alone with your partner. You need a fantasy. It may be even the fantasy about this partner, you know, a certain detail, how she smiles, what to do, blah, blah. And you basically use the partner as a kind of a masturbatory tool to enact your fantasy. It's never, you are never just alone with the partner. So this is the Lacanian twist. How do we usually describe masturbation? As doing it, but just with an imagined partner. You do it to yourself, you imagine it.
You know the Woody Allen line that masturbating is making love to someone I love really dearly.
Yeah, which is your fantasy image of your... Yeah, yeah. Because, again, if this is masturbation, doing it to yourself, but with an imagined partner, Lacan's reply would have been that real sex is just masturbation with a real partner, you know. And I think, now we come to pseudo-activity and all that. I did, a year ago, a Guardian asked me some stupid question about is there still passion today, how to revive sex, and I there gave the only possible formula of authentic love. My idea was this one. I'm sorry if you know the joke. You know how today we have not only dildos, that is to say, plastic penises, we also already have mechanic vaginas. They are called, where I read a strange name, I love it, stimulating training unit, something, it's horrible. It looked like a battery, and then you take the top off, and it has the entrance, and then you can even replace entrance with something which looks like vaginal openings, anal opening, or mouth. Then you can regulate the density, how it shakes, and so on. So my idea for authentic sex today was this one. It answers, I think, your question about pseudo-activity, blah, blah. Let's say I make a date with a lady. We are all serious people who would do that. Naked, you are there mingling on bed. That's not for decent people. You do this. She brings her dildo. I bring my vagina. We put both machines on. We put dildo into vagina. And we just listen to the buzzing. And let's say you are my lady. And then we drink tea. We have a nice conversation. And they are doing the business for us, you know. But now comes my miracle. Our duty to enjoy is covered there. And maybe, if you are a lady, maybe, just maybe, while we are just talking and the machines are doing the superego job of enjoying for us, our hands touch, we embrace, and that would have been the true sex, you know. Not the superego duty, you have to do it there.
Because I must say it's tempting.
Sorry? Yeah, but if we do it, machines will only do it. With you, no hand touching, you know.